Islamic Revolution Guard Corps, IRGC, Navy Commander Rear Admiral Ali Fadavi downplayed Washington's military buildup in the Persian Gulf and had said the IRGC speedboats have the needed capability to sink the U.S. aircraft carriers. Fadavi had said in a meeting with a delegation of Oman's National Defense College in Tehran, the U.S. is not in such conditions that it can threaten us in action, yet it continues making verbal threats. Lieutenant Commander of the IRGC Navy General Alireza Tangsiri said, Iran has armed IRGC Navy speedboats with long-range Qader cruise missiles, which can destroy maritime targets, including frigates and warships. In the Noble Prophet 9 exercises conducted in the Straits of Hormuz, Iran constructed a mock aircraft carrier and proceeded to attack it. The attack was carried out with anti-ship missiles, mines, and a simulated commando raid, which involved troops landing on the flight deck via helicopter and attacking the carrier's superstructure. But a test scenario is different from real-life war. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Iran cannot sink a U.S. supercarrier.
Number 5.
Iran's naval power has even been acknowledged by foes. In a September 11, 2008 report, the Washington Institute for the Near East Policy said that in the two decades since the Iraqi-imposed war on Iran, IRGC has excelled in naval capabilities and is able to wage unique asymmetric warfare against larger naval forces. According to the report, IRGC Navy has been transformed into a highly motivated, well-equipped, and well-financed force and is effectively in control of the world's oil lifeline, the Strait of Hormuz.
Number 4.
The Nimitz-class supercarriers are a class of 10 nuclear-powered aircraft carriers in service with the United States Navy. Apart from that, the U.S. has recently commissioned the USS Gerald Ford. All these have a displacement of around 100,000 tons and overall length of 332.8 meters, or 1,092 feet. To give viewers a perspective, it's about 3 football fields long. These are nuclear-powered, have practically unlimited endurance, and have been used to project power far off from the U.S. mainland.
Number 3.
While the threat that small boats pose to major warships has been apparent for some time, the Pentagon's Millennium Challenge 2002 exercise brought the issue to mainstream attention. In that controversial exercise, small fast boats carrying suicide payloads inflicted heavy damage on U.S. naval forces. U.S. Navy has updated its strategy to counter these kind of attacks. Most small boats lack the range to find and successfully attack aircraft carriers in the open sea. Any boats that did find a carrier battle group would need to navigate a formation of well-armed helicopters and escort warships, most of which would boast actual phalanx gun systems that could chew small vessels to pieces.
Number 2.
The Qader supersonic missile developed by Iran has a range of about 185 miles, or 300 kilometers, is self-guided, and can maneuver to lock onto a moving target. The missile is cheap, easy to launch, and can be deployed in swarms. Together with decoys and chaff, theoretically, it's a formidable challenge for defending naval vessels, but in practice, things are different. Here are the technical problems of using this missile. 1. 185 miles or 300 kilometers means that anything in the Persian Gulf is within easy range of the missile. But outside the Persian Gulf, in the Gulf of Oman, the U.S. Navy can romp with ease beyond the range of the Iranian threat, but well within the operational range of the U.S. carriers. The launch platforms of these missiles could be neutralized from far off. 2. Inside the Persian Gulf also there's a problem. The missile's maneuverability is limited because the steering fins are small to avoid drag during supersonic flight. Therefore, the missile can make steering corrections of perhaps half a mile in the last few miles of approach. This probably explains why all tests so far have been with static targets. U.S. carrier, on the other hand, will perform evasive maneuvers. Though massive, U.S. aircraft carrier can move surprisingly fast with a top speed of more than 30 knots, or about 35 miles an hour. The missile has a 200 kilogram warhead. The warhead could potentially damage a supercarrier, but won't be able to sink it since the carrier are designed with compartments and the damaged parts can be sealed off. It also must be noted that the carriers have Kevlar protection on important parts.
Number 1.
It must be noted that these supercarriers are not alone, but are protected by a squadron of at least two Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and Virginia-class attack submarine. Apart from that, multiple Boeing E-3 Sentry Airborne Warning and Control System AWACS support them. Arleigh Burke-class warships are designed as multi-mission destroyers capable of anti-aircraft warfare (AAW), anti-submarine warfare (ASW), ballistic missile defense (BMD), and anti-surface warfare (ASUW). Arleigh Burke-class destroyers are among the largest destroyers in the world. These can operate in open seas or coastal waters. These are equipped especially to protect the supercarriers. These have Tomahawk cruise missile for land attack, RIM 66M standard medium range SAM for air defense, and RIM 161 standard ballistic missile for Aegis ballistic missile defense. These also have two Mark 141 harpoon missile launcher for anti-ship roll. Two Mark 32 triple torpedo tubes are present for launching Mark 46 or Mark 50 torpedoes. Two MH-60R Seahawk Lamps III helicopters are also present for anti-submarine warfare. Other than these, they're equipped with long-range naval gun and multiple close-in weapon systems. Virginia-class is designed to take out enemy surface vessel, submarines, as well as can strike ground targets. It has 12 VLS vertical launch system and 4 torpedo tubes and is capable of launching tactical Tomahawks, harpoon missiles, and Mark 48 torpedoes. Boeing E-3 is designed to provide a holistic view of the battle space and will be able to detect incoming missiles from long ranges. The Pulse Doppler radar in it has a range of more than 250 miles, 400 kilometers, for low-flying targets like the Qader missile. The Qader missile could somehow manage to get past all the sophisticated security and anti-missile protection on the carrier and get a lucky hit on a vulnerable spot, but that's unlikely. Even if it happens, the carrier will not sink.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.